Islamic militants massacred at least 235 people today in Egypt when they detonated a bomb inside a crowded mosque and brazenly shot at panicked worshippers as they fled the scene. ISIS is the chief suspect for the carnage. President Trump reacted strongly on Twitter, writing in part, quote, "We have to get tougher and smarter than ever before, and we will. Need the wall, need the ban. God bless the people of Egypt." As you might imagine, that did not sit well with Democrats.
I'm disappointed that the president of the United States could not behave like a commander-in-chief and a president that would offer the president of Egypt and the people of Egypt, which I want to do right now, my deepest sympathy and prayers for them. It is absurd and really embarrassing. As a member of the Homeland Security Committee, we know this all the time. We're in classified meetings about this, but it is embarrassing not to acknowledge the pain of a particular nation.
Well, the president acknowledged exactly that in his tweet when he said, quote, "God bless the people of Egypt." Joining us now for analysis from Washington is Lieutenant Colonel Tony Schaefer, a former intelligence operative and a vice president at the London Center for Policy Research. And with me here in New York, Buck Sexton, a radio talk show host and a former CIA analyst. So let's just start off the top, Tony. Sheila Jackson Lee, I mean, come on. This is, you know, she always makes fun of Republicans when Republicans say, "My thoughts and prayers are with victims of gun violence." Now there's terror violence, and she's offering thoughts and prayers. I don't get it.
Where were they 2 years ago when they cut off the weapons the Egyptians needed to go kill these folks? I mean, that was a complete lack of sympathy. Look, the things we're seeing right now, Jesse, are a result of the complete failure of leadership by the Obama White House and by the Obama Congress. You know, they were screaming for assistance. President Obama himself cut off what we used to have this exercise we just started again this year called Bright Star, where we exercise and help train the Egyptians. Where were the Democrats when Obama cut all of that off? They were nowhere to be found. So I think it's not only lunacy that she's saying this, it's disrespectful to the president, who was actually trying to do everything he can to fix the situation. And as every the time they do this, they're grandstanding and will accomplish absolutely nothing except get in the way of progress.
That's true. So let's just talk about the attack itself, Buck. These are, we assume, ISIS militants at this point, and they're going after Muslims praying in a mosque in Egypt. What's going on? That seems to be a complete civil war situation within Islam.
So there's a very active affiliate of the Islamic State in the Sinai. There are a bunch of affiliates around the world that are also going to become, I think, more active with terrorist attacks, engage in more mass casualty events like this because of the losses that the Islamic State has suffered in Iraq and Syria. There's a sense that what was so powerful about the Islamic State before? It was winning, and therefore the propaganda that it was pushing around, those, it was winning in Iraq, it was winning in Syria, that was what they were telling people. Now they've lost Raqqa. Now they're on the defensive. And so you have these other entities, other groups like this affiliate in Sinai that is trying to pick up the terrorist slack, if you will, and have a more prominent role on the world stage. Now, why would they target Sufis? Sufis are a mystical sect of Islam. They are considered by hardliners, and this is actually a debate that's happened inside jihadist circles between al-Qaeda and ISIS and the Islamic State, which is, can you target Muslims who aren't the kind of Muslim you want? Are they takfir? That's the word that they use for them. And Sufis are mystics. They are considered to be actually polytheists by some of these jihadist hardliners. So they attack them to show their purity and to show that the Egyptian people can't, I mean, the Egyptian government can't actually protect its own people.
And
so
the Egyptian government, notorious for treating their enemies the way they treat their enemies. I mean, I can't even imagine, Tony, what the Egyptian military is going to do to anybody they think is responsible for this. What do you predict to be the repercussions after something this heinous?
Well, look, I've met with their chief intelligence officer, and look, they're at a war. This is a war. You do things which are militarily necessary to win that war. And I think they're going to go into this with clear eyes. Yeah. And
I think it's going to be a little tougher than waterboarding. Let's just put it that way.
And rightfully so. I mean, look, as Buck just pointed out, These people are killing anybody, to include their fellow members of the Islamic faith, simply because they don't have this very severe belief that they need to kill people to make their point. So, and the Egyptians have to kill them back. And we have to understand, Jesse, that you need to fight to win. The Egyptians are going to have to do that, and it's going to be bloody.
So president comes out and tweets, we need the wall and we need the travel ban. And I thought it was savvy to link the wall on the southern border with Mexico to national security, because he's saying it's not just about preventing illegal aliens from crossing over the border. It's about preventing the possibility of Muslim radicals crossing the border. And I think that's a pretty effective argument.
Well, as you look at what phase the Islamic State's in now, there are two major concerns. I just spoke to you about the affiliates. That's obviously a huge problem. We just saw that in the Sinai. Then there's also the problem of returnees, of the former foreign fighters who had joined the Islamic State, who are going to try to infiltrate. They've already done this in Europe. We've seen mass casualty attacks in Europe because of this. We know they also want to do this in the United States. And if they didn't want to do it, we'd have to ask the question why it would be so effective for them to get trained operatives into the U.S. for a mass casualty attack. And so when the president's tweeting this out, he's saying, look, ISIS is still very active. We still are in a world where jihadists are trying to kill as many people as possible. We need to do everything that we can. He's not drawing a straight line between a wall and what happened to Sinai. He's drawing a line between the threat of the Islamic State and doing everything he can to his commander in chief to make sure that we are safe here at home.
Yeah, people are making fun of the president. They say, oh, what, do you want to build a wall around Egypt? What is that supposed to be? I just don't think they can even follow him on Twitter. And by the way, he tweeted this about the Egypt attack while he was golfing with Tiger Woods. So he literally has the world at his fingertips, Tony. I'll give you the last
word.
He
could literally do, you know, multiple tasks at the same time. Imagine that. The last guy apparently couldn't. And to that point, look, as Buck was saying, we have to be aware that it's not just Mexican drug cartels who can figure out the way to get illicit goods and people across the border. The bad guys will, too. And the ISIS folks have had aspirations of doing things here. We do know they plant people in both the refugee pipeline as well as any sort of illegal or illicit activity that they can get a hold of. Look, that's why some of the folks have come across out of Libya into Europe, because they've gotten into the refugee stream there. So
this is
not a Muslim ban. The Muslims I've spoken to here, Jesse, don't want the violent Muslims coming here to kill them as well. So the idea here is the president has to do things to set up mechanisms and gateways so that the good folks get through, we maintain commerce, and shut down any potential of the bad guys coming here. It's very
simple.
And if
the travel ban prevents just one bad guy from coming into the United States, it's a success.
Absolutely.
Guys, thank you very much.